Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Adobe Tutorials 101, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make a shiny button in Adobe Photoshop CS4, CS3, or CS2, CS1, if there is a CS1. So let's open it up, and you see I already have it, but I'll show you how to do it. So you can go to File, New, Width 200 pixels, Height 100 pixels, and Background Contents, Background Color. Make sure it's white and black, and OK. Now as you have that, let me just close these down. Just to show you. Okay. Now you should have that. And then you want to make sure all these options up here are all like how I have it. Then you want to go to your rectangle tool and go to your rounded rectangle tool and go right to the corner and make a oval shape. An oval shape, yeah. And then you're going to right click and go to blending options and gradient overlay. Now that you have gradient overlay, click the bar and click the blue you want. I'm going to put right here. Oh, you can pick any. All the colors are up to you. Doesn't matter how I have it. Doesn't really matter. And then you want to put it here and just make it about 40% location. Just make it look like that. And okay. And then you want to go to inner shadow. Go to blend mode. Click overlay. Opacity 75%. Size about 16 or so, or 15. Distance about 7 or 8. Well, 7 is the best. And then OK. Now that's your basic button. Now to make another rectangle around the tool, you want a rectangle around it. And you want to click Style, No Style. That's how your button should look. Now you're going to make another little rounded tool like that. Now if you don't like how it is, you can press the space bar and just move it anywhere you want while you want to change it, like just like that, and let go. That looks pretty good. Now you're gonna go to your right here and you're gonna click overlay, and then you wanna go to your opacity and make it about between 40 or 50, but it's completely up to you. I'm gonna keep mine about 41. And then you want to deselect that. And now that's your glowy part of the button. That looks really nice. Now to add text in your button, you want to go to your text tool and use horizontal type tool. Add it in just like this. And then add your name or whatever you want to use. You can either use anything you want. You can center it just like that, or you can press this button right up here and make it centered, but you can just press your backspace or spacebar. Now once you have that, click the check mark. Oh no, don't click the check mark actually. You're going to want to go to, make sure it's that, and then you're going to go to soft light. Now once you have soft light, that's what your button looks like. If you want to move it, you can just move it down, make it bigger, highlight it. Go to your bar right here, it says TT, and say something about PT. You can make it higher, like 48, and then that's what it should look like. And that's how you do it. And then when you're done, you make sure everything is correct. You're going to click your check mark, and that's your button. That's how you just made your first original button. Now, if you want to save it, you're going to go to File. You're going to go to Save As. You want to go right down to your format right here, and then you want to click JPEG. Make sure you use JPEG, otherwise it will not save correctly and you're not be able to use it for, I don't know, like MySpace, YouTube, or anything you use, or Facebook picture, or whatever, and or background. Then you're going to click JPEG, and then you're going to save it whatever you want right before the .pg, and you're going to name it, I don't know, I'm going to save mine as Tim, because that's what I did. And then you're going to click save. But I usually save right in my desktop, but you can change it up here. But I keep mine desktop. And then you click OK. And save. Now JPEG options, you're going to click it quality 8. And baseline standard. And make sure it's on high and leave it just as it is. And then click OK. Now you minimize this. And there it is. And now this is what it looks like. That's what my button looks like. If we're gonna make it bigger, then go all up to like here and just make it over. But I made mine like that, so that looks pretty cool. So that's how you make a glossy button in Adobe Photoshop CS4, and that's it. Alright, so subscribe, comment, and rate, and look at my other videos. Alright, bye.